Hi guys, that's a good start. Excuse me while I choke. Well, I thought I'd just have a little chat whilst I clean these brushes. I hate this job. Hate it. But I hate putting makeup on with my fingers because just no. And so that's the price you pay for just, you know. But what I use, I'm not affiliated to this company at all. It's called Freedom Pro Studio Brush Bath. And what it is, it's like some soap in a plasticky thing, and you put your brushes, just the dirty bits. Obviously don't put all your brushes underneath, or else the water gets up your, what do they call it, the bit that your brush is held onto, your ferrule. I don't know how you say it. It's spelled F-E-R-R-E-U-L, ferrule. Anyway, your water gets up there, so just like get that end bit in. The state of that. So yeah, so get your water, get your warm water on the end of your dirty brush, and then you swish it around that. Rub it on the back of your hand. Cold water, it's done. So I'll just do one or two because, you know, it's boring for me to do. It's going to be really boring for you to wash. Wash? Watch. Oh, this is going to make me want to pee running water. It's a very pleasant evening now. I'm looking this way because I've got a window there and I just can see through the crack of it where it's up. It's been raining on and off all day. So my washing's had to go in the dryer, which is now turned off because it just makes a horrendous noise. There we go. So yeah, so just for like a few seconds in some warm water, then you get your bath brush. I don't know if you can see that. I'm not very good at these anyway. Right, so that's got some of the soap on it. You can see it's cleaned a bit already, and then you've just swoosh it round. I do it like there. Just swoosh it round. It's all soapy. And then rinse your hand first, obviously. And then just rinse it in a bit of cold water, again not letting it get up your ferrule, because nobody wants that. So I do that, and like I give it another on the back of my hand, and then there's still some soap coming out, so I tip it in the, dip it in the water again. And that's it. No more soap, give it a whack. And from the filthy brown it was, it's back to wet, of course, but the nice clean. And then I get a towel, which I can't find at the moment. Just a sec, it's behind me. There we go, I've got it. All with it. Ow, all without the aid of a safety net. Ta-da! Okay, so then I get a towel, which I keep specially for this awful job. Squeeze out any remaining water and then just give it a little rub. That's what she said. Last squeeze, another little rub, and there. Clean, and then I just stick that on the windowsill for it to dry. I won't do all the brushes, but I've got like a little tiny beauty blender, and what I do with that is hold that under the hot, it is hot, hot water, squeezing it while I do it, then get my, and just give that a good all around there, dig my nail in it, and then I just give it a good damn good thrashing. Oh, excuse me, I went a bit ham on that one. Oh, for God's sake. No, it's lost, it's gone under the shower curtain, I can't get it. Never mind. But that's what I do. I give it a good, and then I hold it under the cold tap and squeeze it until it, anyway. Forget that, you get the idea. And the last thing I'm going to do, what an idiot. Right, then you get these little powder puff things, which I don't use very often because, to be honest, they're no good. But when I do use them, again, under the hot water. Oh God, that was really hot. And these are a bit easier to keep hold of because you could put your fingers. You can put your fingers through the, excuse me, put your fingers through there. And same thing again. Give it a good rub around the old brush bath. And then same as the tiny little beauty blender, just give it a good old, ooh, give it a good old squish about in your hand, and try not to throw it under the shower curtain, never to be seen again. Right, and same thing again, honestly. So I mean about why I hate this job. I'm sorry to make you go through this, really, but I'm thinking, no, if I've got to do it and I hate it, then by God, you're going to watch me do it and hate it too. Because I like that. I'm kind like that. Oh no, I've got one more little brush, actually. I know what you're all thinking. You think, for God's sake, will she just turn that camera? No, I won't. No. And you will watch it to the end. You will. Okay. Give it some good. Turn that round a little bit. Whoa, no. Okay. Forget it. Right, and then. It's looking quite clean again. Okay. The last bit of torch, I've just cut my head off. Some are saying hooray for that. Oh no, it's alright, it's because I'm sitting forward. Okay, then there's this brush, which I love. I use this. This is what I put my foundation on, mostly. It's got little short bristles, very tightly packed. It's very soft and it's beautiful for putting foundation on. And it's called, I think it's called a mushroom brush. And I got this off eBay for 99 pence. It's brilliant, brilliant. And I think if you go onto American eBay site, it's 99 cents. So if you're looking for a bargain foundation applier, look for the mushroom brush. Don't bother with all these fancy stipple brushes and what have you, for however much they are. Actually, no, I've ordered one. Okay. Now, this is quite difficult to not get water to go up its ferrule, because they're just tiny little things, but you can just do your best. And again, if all the hairs fall out, it's only 99 pence. Right, so here we go again. Stick it in the bath. It's a bit like a shaving brush, gentleman's shaving brush. Oh God, I don't know if you can see my hand. You see all the... Don't know if you... Get off. Can see all the foundation on it. It's my daily workout. Just not that I clean my brushes every day, of course. Oh, back to the content. So yeah, hope you guys have had a good weekend. Good Sunday. Oh, it would have been nice if the weather was better here and I could have gone out somewhere and done a bit of vlogging. But no, no such luck, and no luck tomorrow either, because we're in for some wind and rain. Aren't we lucky? Typically British summer. Okay, I think that's okay. Wait a sec. I know you're all dying to see this, aren't you? You are, aren't you? Oh, yes. There you go. See how much cleaner that looks? One thing is, it's a bit awkward to hold as well, because it's an odd little shape. It tends to shoot out of your hands. Right, give it a good rub. People with dirty minds, ignore that, thank you. Okay, I think that's about it. Put it this way. That's as good as it's getting. Okay, right. I think that looks quite clean, don't you? Yeah, it's okay. Ah, I'm putting it on the windowsill. Doesn't want to stay. Okay. Okay, you go behind the mirror. I don't care what you do. Just bugger off. So there. That's an interesting video of how I clean my makeup brushes. Okay, I'll let you go now, guys. I'm just going to carry on cleaning. So, speak to you soon. Bye bye. Like, subscribe. Don't forget to click the bell, or else you won't get any more exciting videos with me scrubbing my brushes. And you don't want to miss that, do you?
No.
Okay. Bye, guys. Love you all.